Hello MechWarriors, how is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today we are playing the Grasshopper 5H. This build dropped out of one of my streams because it was a request from someone and I wanted to show you today because I think I like it. So yeah, what are we doing today? We are using the Grasshopper 5H in a heavy PPC loadout. So the Grasshopper is really nice because of course of its high mounts. So that is very cool. It has jump jets. It is a heavy mag, which makes it so that we can use a lot of double heat sinks in that build here. We're running a light engine 300, makes the mag reasonably fast. And we've got the two medium lasers for backups here. We're running a targeting computer, which helps with targeting weak spots and increases our velocity of the projectiles. So that's really cool. And yeah, again, it's a very straightforward build. Three jump jets to get some pop tart ability. And yeah, what's very important about the build, by the way, is that you put in the medium lasers first and afterwards the heavy PPC. If you do it the other way around, then you would see... Wait, where's the medium laser? There we go. You would see that the PPC is on the lower hard point and you really want them on the high hard point because that is your main weapon. So medium laser first, that goes then down to the lower hard point and then on top of that, the PPC. Skill build looks like this. We have invested a little bit into cooldown and heat management, also a little bit into velocity. So the nodes in the outskirts here, they are kind of optional, but I really liked that. So therefore, velocity, heat management and cooldown in the firepower tree. I was working towards survival, as you can see. I'm not maxed out yet, so I'm going for armor here. I want to go down the full left side of the armor tree. I've got this here, this is my good old heavy mag torso mounted weapon loadout for mobility, torso speed, torso yaw and a little bit kinetic burst and heartbreak. I'm running full cooldown, of course, because we are a very hot build. Although we have that 10% energy heat quirk on the Grasshopper 5H, you really want to max out the cooldown here. We're running 60% rate at deprivation and the consumable slot. And this is the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the two games that are coming. If you have that, as always, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. All right, first game of the day. Yep. We are playing the River City. We are playing a soldier. I want to set up in Go 7 because I wait a lot of people trying to push this side. And I can try to pop tart. Question is, which building should I choose? Probably this one. Oh, there's a guy on the left already. Yeah, he was... we got a locust on the left side, guys. It would be great if I hit them. That was not the best shot in the world, but maybe he shows up again. Is that a tag, Locust? No, wait, that's our tag. Yeah, that's our tag. All right. So that Locust wanted to be cheeky, but at least we have driven him out of his position again. And again, I expect a lot of stuff on the left side of the Citadel here. Our left side, their right side. So we just wait for somebody to pop up. And then we just shoot him. So we can do some early snapshots, no problem, no heat issues at all. Oh, there comes a... Is that a nightshade? Yeah, it is. Let me do something like this. I'm getting a lot of return fire. So that's actually not the best enemy to go up against, but I'm going to do it again. So that guy is pretty orange already. Left side nightshade is orange in the center, just saying. And I think I'm going to pair up with my Supernova here. So we are kind of the mid-range combination, which can deal some serious damage to the enemies if we combine our firepower. Okay, that didn't work. Yeah, again, left side is the side. This is the guy. Was that a hit? Not entirely sure. And we can take it super slow. As long as they are just standing there, I just soften them up with my heavy PPCs. That's my job here. Left side hotel, Medka 2. And I want to get out of this. Can I? Ah! Airstrike coming in. Okay, it's an artillery strike, so that was good. I was able to dodge that. So, yeah, again, we do another Pop-Tart. Got, I think, only one of my PPCs hit that blackjack, but it's still enough. Again, 15 damage is 15 damage. He went to the left. I was thinking he was going to the right to regroup with his team, but he didn't. So, yeah, it's a very, very chill build. Very slow paced in this situation here. We are only peeking. We're not really brawling. Go for hotel, please. He's pushing. Okay, we pull back. Go for center. Open up. Hotel, please. Okay, and now I need to try to block the incoming damage. and get back to second line. This is a Brawling Scorch. Very scary, of course. Alright. Let's try to back up. Try to get behind this thing. They are pushing us really hard, but we are kind of holding our ground. The thing is, we need to shield the Supernova from the enemy. This one is one of our biggest assets here at the moment. So, yeah, keeping that guy safe is kind of my priority here. Nitra is dead. That guy is maybe dead? No, not quite. But I think left side is okay to peek again. Yeah, it is. Alright. It's kind of safe here. We go for Chainfire to pop his toy. Nah, never mind. Quick draw. So, yeah, my team has done a very good job just holding the ground. Why is he not moving? Every time that happens. Damn it! I anticipate movement and then they don't move anymore. Or they move to another direction. Holy crap. Oh my god. But yeah, that's just heavy PPC sniping or poking. Very chill. Got his arm, which was not that valuable. But anyway, he's dead. I want to get that kill. Can I? No. He's still fresh, isn't he? Yeah, he's still fresh. Pew. Alright, oh my god. That team. And we've got the Lerm Supernova all the way in the back. So that guy kind of did it wrong. He was staying out of the fight for the whole time. Just trying to shoot his damage to the enemy. While my Supernova was kind of pretty close. He got a good locks all the time. And there's a guy in the back. I love Spidey. Do you want to get me? Come on, just kill me. Just kill me. You can have to kill. You can have to kill. Come on, get out of here. No? Okay, he dropped. I was really hoping that he wanted to get another shot to my center here. But yeah, it's just a straightforward build. You got the two heavy PPCs that you shoot. You got the two medium lasers if something gets close. Or if you want to amplify the damage. And if your team does it right and gives you some time to actually shoot, you will do pretty okay. So let's have a look at the end score before we go over to the next one. We got a 12-2 here. It's kind of a stomp, but yeah. We got 0 kills, but 11 assists, 571 damage. We got one component destroyed, and that's the first game. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing Alpine Peaks. We are playing Assault. We are playing Peaking Game, because we are on Alpine Peaks, and we try to figure out where the enemies are. There's a guy. It's far too far away here. But maybe they're coming closer a little bit. Actually, if they're not pushing this, we shouldn't be here. Why are we defending this? Guys, we need to figure out where the enemies are. Just staying here does nothing. They are not in Gulf 8.
Yeah, they're around Gulf 10. They're sort of perched up on the hill
there. Yeah, so we can just push this. We don't have to stay behind that ridge, guys. Let's get out of this shitty position there.
Something really weird.
This is actually a very bad position. So I usually do not like this Gulf 7 thing. And I really hope my team comes with us. They have a UAV and hotel in Gulf 9. Now, problem is, of course, my pitch angle.
Pop a UAV in Gulf 9.
And, of course, my velocity. Alright. So, at the moment, we are only taking snapshots, trying to get into a good position to trade some hits here. And with trading, I mean shooting and not getting hit in return. Okay. We found the light lance. So, that's a thing. Ah, okay, he was too fast for me. Our assault mechs are a little bit behind. Don't push too hard, we still have some assault mechs who want to catch up. Oh, they have taken the Nerd Hill. Oh, alright. Alright, alright, alright. Okay, Hotel 10, so it seems.
Delta's leg is open.
Can we get an angle on somebody? We're pushing them back in Hotel 10. Okay, that's a Jenna with MRM, so it seems. Okay, we go for this. We miss it. Okay, that was only the arm. I should really take more time to aim. So, with that build that I'm running here, with a pinpoint build that really delivers good damage, you should really take a little bit of time to aim. Just half a second or so. It doesn't give you... It doesn't give you any drawback, and you can actually try to hit your targets with that. Okay, I think it's time to push Hotel 10 then. Cicada,
yeah,
see that?
Running.
So if I just hold still for like a friction of a second, then I think I actually hit my targets here. Alright, my arm is critical, my rear is critical? What? Critical rear? Huh. Now again, the pitch angle is not the best, so we need to figure out where the rest of the enemies are. Maybe we can get an angle on this guy. Get a frag in the back. That was actually a good shot. Maybe we crit something. Oh, he's open big time. Alright, let's go for him though. Not enough. I really want to get that cataphract there. Oh, there they are. Alright. So, India 10 it is. India 10. Hmm. So, my team... I'm kind of jealous on the teammates who actually have arm-mounted weapons. Can we get a... No. We cannot get a hidden aim. Ah! You know what? I'm going to drop here. Oh, wait, no. I can't do that. Just repositioning. Driving him down. Let's pin him down. Is that possible? Nope. I need to get a little bit lower here. Cataphract is probably dead. New target. Okay. And the thing is, we need to come back a little bit. So they got two kills, we only got one. And I think it's time to put out a little aggression to the battlefield. So I really hope my team follows up when I'm going into that king crab. It is obviously a Lurm crab, which is getting Lurm from the outskirts. And got pinpoint from me here. Alright, I think that's going to work. That was the center, it was good. Can you keep damage on the king crab? Okay, my team is not really coming with us. Okay, that guy is fresh. And I'm going back to second line now.
Golf?
Yeah, golf, please. Please kill golf. Alright, we go for the center. Okay, that guy is dead. And Foxtrot, let's keep up the push left side, guys. Okay, we go for heat vision. It's easier to target the enemy with that. I leave the push for the Hellbringer here, so he has still a lot of armor. And in my condition, I shouldn't be exposing myself anymore. Only for a very brief amount of time. Only when I'm very comfortable. And yeah, I think it's kind of working out here. Okay, Thanatos. Problem is, of course, don't get too close in this build. Because the heavy PPCs have that 90 meters minimum range. And if you're getting shot, or if you're getting pushed and underrun, ouch. I want to pull back here. If you're getting shot and underrun, you cannot defend yourself. Two medium lasers are just nothing. So we twist with the left side now, we shield with the left, because that's my still strong side. Got the cicada. And now I slowly get the hang of it here. Alright. I think it's working out. Here comes the Timberwolf. Kill the Timby, please. I guess we can push up. Oh, maybe not. Okay, I need to go back instantly. Like, my King Crab is done. How's the Cyclops doing? Couldn't really see it. Hmm. Guys, should we just swarm them? The good old...
Yeah, please.
Okay. Got that. Ooh, this is actually not... Oh my god. There goes my arm. There goes that guy. Ah, I want to get up here. Okay, we got an Atlas with MRMs and large lasers. It's a very scary build. Very scary against me right now. But we got him. We got... Okay, we only got the Jenna left. Oh, wow. Pin him down. Nah, man. I wanted to kill his leg here, but we can maybe do it with the mediums. Yeah. And now, this is the situation I was talking about. Now he underrun me and I couldn't bring my PPCs to the point. Wow, what a game! That was very awkward in terms of dynamic, but we kind of pushed him down from the hill, and then went down and then we pushed up the hill again. So it was kind of a hill climbing simulator here. Anyway, we got 2 killing blows, 10 assists, 1 kill mouse damage dealt, 639 damage done, 3 components destroyed. That was a solid round and that was your heavy PPC grasshopper. Hope you liked the video. If you did, as always, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel. And I hope to see you on the battlefield, everybody. Goodbye.